Hi guys. Hopefully this little circuit will help me to set the timing on the battery welder. As you can see, we've got some bits and pieces in here. We've got a 555 timer, 470 microfarad capacitor, two 10K resistors, and a 470 ohm resistor, and also a little 0.01 picofarad capacitor as well, I think, something like that. I've put all the details in the link below anyway. But basically, as it is, if I touch those two wires, the blue light comes on for 5 seconds, approximately. And the next step is to put a little potentiometer in instead of one of the resistors on the other side, and then we'll be able to adjust that. So that's the next step. Hi guys. I have just got my battery welder, spot welder, sorted out so that there's a proper timer on it. This is obviously, when you're trying to do spot welds, you need to make sure that you have the same, you have the current going through it for the same amount of time every time. And if you're just hitting a button each time, you can't really set that properly. So what I've got, if you look in here, is a, zoom in a bit, is a little circuit board built on a 555 timer. Let's come out again. Very, very simple. All we've got is a connector here, which is for our power, pause and neg in. We've got a connector here, which is for a link through to a potentiometer, which is on the front. We have a little LED to indicate when it's active. And the chip itself is a 555 timer chip. And basically the way it works is, when I push a button, which is connected to this switch here, this connector here, when I push a button, this will trigger for a preset time. And when it triggers, I'll just zoom back out again. Sorry, wrong way. When it triggers, it kicks off this solid state relay. And as you can see, we have on this side, we have low voltage, 12 volts. And on this side, we have 240 volts. So when I put 12 volts onto this solid state relay, it will short out the connection to the other side and put 240 volts through to the microwave oven transformer. And I'm sure you've probably already seen other videos of the how a microwave oven transformer can be turned into a spot welder. As you can see, if I can let you down there, there are two coils of 50 millimeter squared welding wire. That's wire you would use for a stick welder. So there's two turns of that are going through at the top. And then coming through here, and if you look up, if I can get this right, there's two terminals just basically pushed straight into that, into the welding wire. They're pushed in about 4 or 5 centimeters, or 2 inches or so. And like I said before, this is the knob for adjusting it. That adjusts the timer. Now, when I was doing this and trying to figure out what sort of a button I was going to use to trigger it, I knew I needed a switch that would be very instantaneous and would be, you could basically tap it very quickly and it would trigger the SSR for the correct amount of time. Some switches I tried were very, very slow, so when I tapped the switch, it basically didn't release quickly enough. And it took me a bit of time to try and figure out what I should use as a switch for that. Went up into the roof space. I was rummaging around for a good 10 or 15 minutes, trying to find something in the roof space that was old and wasn't being used that would have a switch in it that I could take. And then it suddenly dawned on me. I was going through a box of rubbish and I heard a little click and I, what was that? And I looked down. Yep, it was obvious the whole time. A mouse. A mouse has a switch on. Mice have lots of switches. So what I've done is I've taken this mouse apart. There's two micro switches, one on either side here. There's actually a third one as well, but it's activated by the scroll wheel, but it's gone now, so I'm not worried about that. There's two micro switches, one on either side, and if I push that button and point at this, you can see it triggers my little timer circuit. And as I said, the timer circuit is controlled by this knob. So at the moment, if I push the button very quickly, if I turn that knob to say halfway, push that button, much longer pulse. And if I turn this up all the way full, the pulse should be about 2 seconds, second and a half or so. Now, this isn't the final job in this final version of this particular system, but it does work. Obviously that long one is far too long, so I'll turn it down. That looks like it might be too short, so I'll turn it up a wee bit, and that's probably still a bit on the long side. But what I'll do is I'll get a battery and we'll have a go at welding some tabs on the battery. So I think you can see that all right. Turn that down to where I had set it earlier. That seems to be about right. These are very old Duff batteries, are not worth much. As you can see, I've been practicing on this one a few times, so it may not weld very well to that one, but we'll see. So it's a bit of a fitter. Haven't quite got the hang of it yet how to do this, but okay, there we go. So if I push that button, that is a pretty good weld. That's on there tight. Might even be slightly too much. Do it again. There you go. Very little heat there. And that's well welded on there. Let me turn that down a fraction. Give it a little slightly shorter duration of pulse. There you go. Let's see how there you go. That's properly welded on. So that's it. Like I say, it's not finished. There's a lot of wee adjustments I can do to it. This potentiometer I'm using is the wrong size. I'm going to try and get a smaller pot for this. This one was actually, it's just an old pot that I managed to get out of a radio or a cassette player. And excuse me. Yeah, it was it's a stereo pot, 250k stereo pots, and what I'm actually after is a 10k pot, so that's on its way, and it'll give me a lot much finer adjustment to make this all work a bit better. So anyway, that's it. Very pleased. It's working well, makes good welds, and all I have to do is a wee tap. Bye for now. Okay, here's a very quick update on the spot welder. Since I last showed you it, I have put in a capacitor and a resistor across the, or a capacitor in line with the switch, and a resistor across the capacitor. And the reason for that is now I can push the button, I hold it down, and as you can see, it doesn't continue, the pulse doesn't continue on. So I can set the time very accurately. And if I can get this to focus, you can see that's a really good spot weld with very little burn, and it's holding very tight. There's hardly any heat there at all. In fact, that's stone cold. A few seconds later and that's stone cold. So I'll just do another one. Push the button, can hold it in as long as I like, and this doesn't continue on with the spot weld like it was doing before. So don't have to worry about bashing the button very quickly. If I want a quick spot weld, I can just push it up, and so long as I don't double tap it, it's fine. And like I say, that was very simple. All I did was put a capacitor in line with the switch and put a resistor across the capacitor so that the capacitor then discharges. And that works a treat. Thanks. Bye.